Hello all, I am Pallavi Bhujbal, working as assistant professor in the Department of Computer Engineering at AISSMS, Institute of Information Technology. I welcome you all for this session. I am going to explain you the network layer and the routing protocols. In this session, we will cover this point. So, the introduction, we will see introduction of network layer, how the routing and forwarding work on this network layer. So, for that forwarding and receiving the packets, we need some algorithms, some routing algorithm. So, we cover in this. So, now we'll see the introductory part of network layer. So what exactly the network layer is? So if we see that ISO model, OSI, open system interconnection model, so the main function of network layer or the third layer of OSI model. This network layer is situated at third layer, that is delivery of data packets from the source to the destination across multiple hops or links. It also controls the operation of subnet. I elaborate this topic so when the data is to be sent, first of all we see a little bit block diagram for the network layer. Here, which is connected to transport layer and data link layer. So that network layer accept data from the transport layer. This accepting data from here, from the transport layer, divides it and encapsulates it into packet and send to the data link layer. Okay, understood? So what the network layer is doing? Network layer accepting the data from the transport layer, divides the data and encapsulate into packet, and that packets of data send over the data link layer. The reverse procedure is done during the receiving data. Means this process, we are encapsulating and dividing the data when we are receiving the data from the transport layer. And when we reverse the procedure is done during the transmit or receiving the data, it will reverse. The network layer is responsible for routing also. Routing packets from the source host to the destination host. The routes can be based upon static table that are rarely changed, or they can be automatically updated depending upon network connection. So this is the network layer. I explained it. Already I explained the functions of network layer. Now we'll see the different duties which will perform by the network layer also. So network layer perform 5 duties, different duties will perform by the network layer. In that, first is inter-networking. Inter-networking is done by this layer. If we go for the second, so the most important is addressing. Yes, obviously. When we are connecting with the any network, that time we need some addresses. Yes? If we want to go anywhere from one place to another place, from one source to another destination, obviously we also need some addressing. So same like that, that network layer is responsible for the addressing of our data from one place to another place. Third is routing. So if we are going from one place to another place, obviously we need some route, we need some fixed path. So similarly, in the networking, network layer also responsible for routing the data from one source to the another. Fourth duties which is done by the network layer is packetizing. And last one, fifth one is fragmentation. So these are 5 duties which will perform by the network layer, and I will elaborate the third duty, routing and floating. Okay, so in the next slide we'll see what is the routing and the floating. This is the one thing which is responsibility is taken by the network layer when we are performing, when we are sending our data from one place to another place. So if you understood, we'll go for the next. As I told you, I will elaborate the routing and the floating. So we'll see the introduction of routing process and the flooding process. So the routing, route. So this is the process of selecting a path for the traffic in a network or between or across the multiple network. Means when we are sending our data in our network from one place to another place, so selecting a path for traffic in network or between across a multiple network, we are using the routing. So internet is the combination of network connected by routers. Okay, so the general purpose computer also forward packets and perform the routing. They have no specially optimized hardware for this task. So the routing process usually direct forwarding on the basis of the routing table, and that routing table maintained by each router which we are using in our path. So this is the routing. If we go for the flooding, yes. So every router, which we are using to transmit our data, or which we are selecting to send our data, that every router should make decision based on the local knowledge, not on the basis of entire network, to implement this flooding is used. In flooding, every incoming packet is sent out on every outgoing line except the one it arrived on. But it produces vast number of duplicate packets. So remaining things I will explain by the example. Okay? So the flooding occurs when a router uses a non-adaptive routing. So what is the meaning of non-adaptive routing and the adaptive routing? Non-adaptive means decision of routing is not based the current topology and the traffic. So the choice of a route to use to get from source to destination is computed in advance. It's offline and downloaded to the router when the network is booted. This procedure sometimes we can call as a static routing because it does not respond to failure. So this kind of routing can say as non-adaptive or the static routing. You see the examples of routing and flooding in next slide. So if you see here, so we are considering this is the source port and this is the destination port. Multiple routers are connected here. If we labeled it with the R1, R2, R3. Process of routing, we are sending our packets from one source to the another destination, okay, by a specific route. So if you see here that arrow path, that arrow indicates the path of routing, means our data is transmitted from source to R1, R1 to R5, R5 to R4, and then we'll go on the destination port. So in that routing, we use only one dedicated path. There are multiple paths are available. If we see here, we can transmit our data from R1 to R2, R2 to R3, R3 to R4. And then for the destination. Same, the third part is this, R1 to R6, R6 to R7, R7 to R5. So we are considering there are three routes are available, but in the routing decides only one optimal path, one dedicated path when we are sending our data from one place to another place. So here our path is source to R1, R1 to R5, then to the R4 and to the destination. So when we are using routing, there is only one dedicated path, or our data which is coming from one source, it will transmit only on one route. Okay? So the route the data packets by using the optimal path. So there is a fixed path when we are using the routing. This process is not more reliable, but when we are using routing, there is very less traffic is occur. Why? Because you are using one optimal path. So, have you understood? That is the routing. This is the routing process in which we are using only the one dedicated optimal path. When we are using optimal path, one optimal path, it means there will on the destination port no chance of the duplicate packets. Okay. So we'll go for flooding process. As I explained, flooding is not has any dedicated path. And flooding do not have any dedicated path. Yes. It means what? Whatever data is coming from the source node, whatever the data packets are coming from this source node, we transmit over, again we will give the name of this router. So here, one dedicated path is given here. But in flooding, this is the routing in which we are using this path. But flooding, what will happen? That router 1 will send the packets R2, R5 and R6 at a time. Similarly, that R2 will forward this packet to R3, R2, R5 and R7. It means that flooding do not have a dedicated path. That router will send that data all over the routers. After that, the destination port will accept data from multiple paths. It means it will create the duplication, obviously. So once first data is, you can consider as a original data, but in the flooding, after the original data we'll get the multiple data on the same port. That is called a duplication. So in flooding, there is not fixed path. So R1 router is sending the data packets to all paths. That is the flooding. So this is more reliable. Right? Because if one of the link is disconnected or one of the network is get failed, so there is no chance of failure of our data. It means our data will transmit over the destination on the same time, on the same manner. So this is the flooding. In next lecture, we will cover the different algorithms which we are using for the routing process. Okay, thank you.